In this video, I'll be demonstrating some of the new ways I've been employing tremolo techniques into my guitar playing, primarily focusing on what I've been calling glitch tapping. There may be another name for it, but it's basically just hammering on multiple notes in the same fret. I wanted to take this concept of tremolo, which comes from this Latin word that means tremble or tremor, and I wanted to take it away from its more delicate connotations of classical guitar technique or the pedal that's commonly associated with electric guitar, that's just pulsating sound, and I wanted to make this rapid mechanical style of tremolo, one akin to a slapback delay, but under my control, something being produced by my fingers quickly and effectively. And I basically stumbled upon it by accident using pretty standard multi-finger tapping. This is using six fingers. And by accident, I shoved three fingers into the space of one, something like this. And from there, I was really into it. I was practicing it a lot, and I was eager to put it into the band I'm in called Little Tybee. I'll have a couple of members from that band join me for an example. I'll show you how I began to use it. So that was an excerpt from a song called Hearing Blue. And in that example, I'm using a butterfly tapping technique and combining it with the glitch tapping technique. So butterfly tapping is a percussive style tapping, similar to drum rudiments or something like that. And I'm just mixing in the glitch, and it sounds like a glitch in the middle of it. And I really enjoyed the way that sound there. And to give you some context, I use it in some other Little Tybee songs where I made it a little bit more legato. So there's a song called Left Right where I use it and I slide into it. And I'll show you an example of that. So from there, I was eager to integrate the technique into both of my hands playing. I was accustomed to these thumped arpeggios. Thumping is a double thumb technique that I got from Victor Wooten, the bass player. And I would put the glitch before the arpeggio. So this is an E minor 7 arpeggio. And I would put the glitch right before it, which is just basically three repetitive notes. And from there, I started doing it all over the place with my left hand and trying to basically sneak it into different parts. So there's a new song that will be on our new Little Tybee record in 2015, and here's an excerpt from that. After I got accustomed to emphasizing specific notes with my left hand on the lower register, I wanted to do it in a more legato fashion in the higher register. So I do that in a new Little Tybee song called Don't Quit Your Day Job. I'll show you an example of it. Thank you. this next example, I'll continue using the thumping technique, but I'll add a pluck of the fingers, which is commonly used with the thumping technique, a down up, pluck, 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 something like that. And I'll combine it with the glitch tapping, and it creates its own diverse kind of tremolo effect where you have a mechanical kind of repetition really quickly with different timbres. I'll show you in this example. In this next example, I'll use the glitch tapping technique with both hands. So if you notice in the last example, I included my pinky for a second. And it was pretty difficult to get the pinky, especially on the right hand, developed, but I wanted to come up with an exercise to really work on it with both hands. So I'll show you that in this next example. After I got the pinky going in my right hand with the glitch tapping, I wanted to include it with a thumping, I wanted to include it with my left hand, and I actually wanted just to have one continuous back and forth rhythm using all of my fingers kind of in a row. So I tried to do this in this major 9 arpeggio I'll show you now. After some experimenting, I realized that you could switch strings in the middle of the glitch. So rather than hitting one note repetitively, you could articulate a whole chord, something like this. So I started experimenting with that. Here's an example using a minor major 7 arpeggio. After that, I threw in some understrumming. I love the challenge of trying to implement these techniques into new little Tybee material. So in this next example, which should be on our new record, I'm using the understrumming, the string skipping, the glitch tapping. I'm trying to mix it all together into one groove. And I'm actually hitting my pinky ring, and then I'm hammering on the index and middle at the same time, and then immediately followed by the thumb. So I'll show you that here. Thanks for watching. I would really love to see what y'all could come up with using any of these techniques. I don't claim to have invented them. I'm sure they've been done, but I just love to see them in action. So feel free to tag us or hit us up on Facebook. Our band is Little Tybee. I also teach on Skype and Band Happy. In this next example, I'm going to try to just mix everything together willy-nilly. So here we go. Special thanks to Ibanez Guitars for making all this possible. In the video, I'm playing the Ibanez Iron Label S Series 8 string. Thanks, y'all.